You're in for a real treat. This is an orchestra rock concert. So the kids have been working very hard. This is a fun concert, so make sure your cell phones are off because you're going to want to enjoy the program the kids have for you. Starting up the program is next year's 7th and 8th grade orchestra. This is the 6th and 7th graders from this year, and we had one rehearsal on this. It went really well, and all 120 of us were stuffed in one little room, so we're enjoying this big stage show. So this is Moon Dance.
Thank you.
some awards, and I'll try and move quickly. First, I have a lot of students in here, very talented students, and there are some that were in the Wichita Youth Symphony this year. So if you were in the Wichita Youth Symphony this last year, please stand and be recognized. And also we have for 7th and 8th grade, All-City Orchestra that they can be in, where they spend kind of a weekend clinic with one of our various strings teachers, and then perform at Century 2, and Channel 12 News is there, so it's kind of a cool thing. If you were in All-City 7th and 8th graders, please stand. Okay, and we also have some 6th graders. I had quite a few ensembles this year, and with 7th and 8th grade, especially I'm all by myself, so I'm very proud that every single ensemble from Robinson this year got an ensemble, or got one. So if you were in an ensemble this year, please stand. That's the highest rating that you can get at the award. So. Next, we also have some students that took solos to Solo Ensemble Festival, and they did very, very well. I was there like all day with solos and ensembles, so if you had a solo this year at Solo Ensemble Festival, please stand. Okay, now the orchestra in front of you, we at festival this year, of course, those were our refined pieces that I beat them with daily for, 4 months when we went to contest last month. And we got 2 perfect scores, an almost perfect score, so I'm very proud of them. That's the highest that anybody in the district got. And we also got 1 in sight reading, so, and that's the orchestra that's here in front of you. So. And then when we went to San Antonio just last weekend, we were participating in what was a little mini workshop this year. And we had an almost perfect score from him. He said to me when he found out that they'd only played half of them in this group, or their second year playing and the other half in the third year, and then there's a few of them that played longer, he said, "Oh, just rip up that score." So it was almost perfect. He was amazed, and his eyes about popped out when I told him. So they got a gold rating in the top of the park at San Antonio, so I'm proud of them. Okay, now with that group, this year I have several 6th graders that I'm calling my hot shots, and they played with the 7th and 8th graders all year, and they worked on with their private teachers. They're all in Youth Symphony, and so I wanted to challenge them because they were in a beginning class. And so they came in the mornings and played with the 7th and 8th graders, Amberly Tran. There's some hot collies from my hot shot. Allison Key. Oh, and my daughters need to learn the signal. My lovely models here. Key. Recognize, and he is playing the whole program, and most of the music he has only played with the kids one time. We're going to go back through some of the songs today that the 8th graders had their picnic. They got rescheduled today, so I know he was in someone in pain, but he's doing a great job. When I told him the other day some of the parts are missing, I said, "Oh, just make some up," and he said, "Oh, that's okay, that's what we do." So Mr. Sean Whalen, and I have a stand up, Sean, as you get. Will you stand up? I can't see. Okay, next we have two of my students that also play electric guitar and electric bass, and our ending song is Cashmere, and they're going to do a whopper of a job. So we have Zoe and Nick. Yes, thank you. Okay, my section leaders for this year, I had my first violins right here. Okay, we meet over two class periods, so I kind of have two leaders, and so I have kind of two concert masters. One is up here, Alyssa Byers, and then I put the other one, she's my co-pilot in the back, and Allie. Those are my two concert masters. She's our leader. Okay, and then in second violin for class was Brittany and Madeline. Okay, and for viola on our two classes was Amira and Nick. Okay, my cellos, Tia. Okay, and on my bass section, the trophy shop where I get my things, this little old couple, they're so precious to me, and they kind of didn't do it how I wanted. It was supposed to say the three amigos on their trophies, because that's kind of what they are, so I gave them all their trophy. We've had a good time picking on them this year, so they're all kind of one group, so they each get an award. So Calvin, Casey, and Nolan. Some of these, because some of the kids said last year the kids were looking at them. So, okay, I have down most improved player, and even today I was watching in class as my student teacher was conducting, and she was moving with the music. I was like, yes, and I was so impressed. And this is an eighth grader that I've kind of watched over sixth and seventh grade. This is an eighth grade, and most improved is Miss Zaria. Director's Award, and their names will go on a plaque that hangs in the orchestra room that we're in at least part of the year, and there's a plaque on the wall, and their names will be on there with 2014-15 school year, and I have two this year, and basically these students show leadership in supporting the orchestra, helping out, helping other students, being here, and also being a leader on their part. So I have Mr. Nick Flores. And Alyssa Myers. Okay, next I wanted to thank my assistant comes in with the sixth grade. There she is, Mrs. House. She did a really good job with me this year. And without you, I would go to pieces. So this is for you. Okay, Alexa, do you want to come out? I've known Alexa. She was my violin student when she was, let's see, five? Yes, all the way through, and now she's going to be an orchestra student, an orchestra teacher now. And so I have some tips for her to becoming a junior Mrs. Hutchins. And my tips are, first, you're going to need good and plenty lot of students. Then you want to work right away on tone so that their bow arm doesn't shrivel up and have raisinets. That's what we work on right away is tone, okay? Okay. And while doing this, some students may crunch a lot with their bow, which is somewhat painful in the beginning days. I suggest suggest a lot of stoppers for the sound, including bow tubes, possibly earplugs, and then on the way home, most probably you're going to need some Tylenol. Finally, you'll have your symphony, but don't expect $100,000 on your payday. The other day, it was so hot in that room, and I gave him all some water, and I said, okay, Nick, just start playing something for us. So he started playing, and the kids started jamming, and they started doing a little bit of improv, and he was like, can we do this in our concert? So they want to show you a little bit what they did. So.